So last time we went through, this creates a handle to a function. I've already got my function defined. I'm going to go back here. Here's chapter four. Come on, slow machine. Chapter four material. There it is. I've created a function, square two. This creates a handle to square two. This finds the root. And let me show you what square two is right there. There's the function. But it shows how to use ellipses. So the function value equals x dot raised to the second power squared. Continued on the next line. These three dots mean continued on the next line. And then subtract 4. So that's all the function's doing. It's x squared minus 4. Go back here. This assignment with the at in front of the function, it makes a handle. We can treat the handle just like we're using the function. This can be useful. In the more advanced topics, getting a handle can be useful. I'm just going to show you how to do it right now. F0 is a function that finds the roots of this function described by the handle. So I'm going to run it. Let's see. Go back home and editor. There we go. I wanted run sectional, just run the highlighted stuff. So I'm just going to run the highlighted stuff. And it tells me the 0 of the function is negative 2, right there. If I go to the next section, I get to choose where I start. This time I started with 0. It's looking for a root near 0, and it found negative 2. I'm going to try plus 3 and negative 3. So this function has two roots, plus and minus 2. This has two roots, plus and minus 2. So this particular section ought to pick up both of them, and it does. The first estimate at 3, it goes down to 2 and says, ah, there's your root at 2. So this is your initial guess when you're using F0. You can also do this. It will evaluate the function for a certain value, and it's looking for the variable x, which it was actually defined up further in the script. It's not defined here. We would have to set it to a value. So I'll choose x equals 4. And then I'll run this section again. This time it ought to run just fine. So x squared minus 4, 4 squared minus 4 is 12. So that's what the fval does. I showed you guys the profiler before. So I run the profiler. Basically, it tells me how fast things go. So if I want to improve my code, make it go faster, this profile can help you find out where the computer is spending its most time. Profile on, starts the profiler, profile viewer, brought up the profile view, which I just closed, and this turns off profiling. Okay. And then, of course, this will just give me, there, I just run the section again. I'm just going to keep getting the answer 12. X squared minus 4. Finds x squared minus 4. Okay. Now, we're going to use functions now. We're going to do something a little different. We're going to start using what are called control structures. For, let's say we want to find the sum of squares from 1 to 5, which is 1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 16 plus 25. What we'll do, we can do it using vectors. If I just want to find the sum of the squares from 1 to 5, I can just do this. Just take x squared, and that'll, and then I can do sum of x. Of answer, actually. This finds the squares of the numbers from 1 to 5, and this finds the sum. I can also run the function. Max number 5. Oops. And I did mean sum square, I didn't mean sum squew, or whatever it is. What this is doing, so I'm calling this function, which is right here. I put in, so max num is 5. It initializes the output variable, which displays right here. A for loop. This is a for loop. For starts with for, ends with end. For your variable equals a vector, and in this case the vector is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. If I put a max number of 6 in, it would do the vector from 1 to 6. Max number 7, 1 to 7, and so forth. So for each element in the vector, this is a temporary variable. It's called an index. Instead of using I, which is the square root of negative 1 in MATLAB, I use my I. And I'm going to display my I. So the first time through the loop, my I equals 1. And then you take 0 plus my I squared, which is 1, equals the new fmat out, which makes it 1. Second time through the loop, my I equals 2. This variable here, fmat out, is 4 plus whatever it was before. It was 1 before, so 4 plus 1 is 5. Third time through, you're going to add this squared to it, 9. We're going to add 9 to what we had before. So we're going to get 14. Fourth time through. Let's see, 16 plus 14 is 30. And then fifth time through, 25 plus 30 is 55. And then finally, once it gets there, it says my I equals 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. It gets to 5. That's the maximum my I hits. When it gets to 5, it says, okay, I'm done. I'm just going to go through this vector. I'm just going to go through all the elements of this vector, and when I run out, I stop my loop. I stop this for loop. So that's how a for loop works.